Hello students. So in the series of neural network, we have seen about the simple neural network introduction, then what is artificial neural network, what are neurons, and what is perceptron, and in the last lecture we have seen about the multi-layer neural network. Fine. So there is one more term that is used in the concept of neural network is back propagation. So what is back propagation in the field of neural network? So simply the classification, the neural network is used for the classification and nothing else. Back propagation learns by iteratively processing a self set of training data samples. Fine. Learns by iteratively, so it is a iterative kind of procedure. For each sample, weights are modified to minimize the error between network's classification and actual classification. Fine. So the task of back propagation is to reduce the error by iteratively update the weights. So in this case, our task is to reduce the error and nothing else. What are the steps in backpropagation algorithm? The first step is initialize the weights and biases. How the weights are initialized? As we have seen in the last class, the weights should be taken randomly. We will start with the random weights. After that, the weights will be updated in each iteration, such that the error should be reduced. The weights in the network are initialized to random numbers from the interval of minus 1 to 1. Fine. Each unit has a bias associated with it. The biases are similarly initialized to random number from the interval minus 1 to 1. So your weights and the bias should be from the similar range of minus 1 to 1. Step 2 is feed the training sample. Step 3 is propagate the inputs forward. We compute the net input and output of each unit in the hidden and output layer. So your task in the neural network of the back propagation is the how you are going to propagate the inputs. So in the third step, the input should be propagated in the forward direction from input to output layer. Step 4, back propagate the error. So at least at the last point, you are going to assume that this much error you have encountered. Now just go back and reduce this error or update the weight in the step 5. Update weights and biases to reflect the back propagated error. And step 6 is terminating condition. So what we have seen here is that our task is reducing the error. Then how we are going to know that how much error has been occurred? In such a way, first you will start by the inputting the training samples. It will move in or propagate in the forward direction. At the last, you will see that how much error has been occurred. Now just go back, fine, and reduce the error. This is why we call it as an iterative process. And why we are going back? In order to reduce the weight. That's why this type of phenomena is known as back propagation. This is the simple architecture of your neural network. We will see that how the back propagation is happening through the hidden layer. Fine. So here you can see that input vector is x and weight vector is w. Weights are always associated into the connections between the input layer and the hidden layer. Then there is some weighted sum and some active activation functions that we will use. Activation functions are nothing but some kind of threshold values. If the threshold value goes to that particular condition, satisfy this some particular threshold, then we will do this, otherwise do this. So this is how this activation function will work. We will see the detailed activation function or the type of activation function in the next class. Then we will apply the bias that we have randomly selected in the previous steps, and after getting all these things we will receive the output Y. The input to unit J are outputs from the previous layer. These are multiplied by their corresponding weights in order to form a weighted sum, which is added to the bias associated with unit J. So this is simple structure of your one node. Fine. A non-linear activation function F is applied to the net input. At the last, we will have the function F, non-linear activation function F, in order to receive the output.